welcome back, everybody. I want to do a little video here on connecting rods because I've had some questions on these. I've had some, there seems to be some confusion about it. One of the things I want to talk about is the type of pin that you may or may not have with your connecting rod. Now, as you can see, I've got some C-clips that I just took out of the package here. Now, this is the first type of connecting rod I want to talk about. We're getting ready to put this Big Block 4 together. This is it's just a 390 FE motor. It's basically stock. But you can see that the type of piston pin that these have is what they call a full floating pin. Now, we know, just like pretty much any other piston, these pins are going to float through the bores in the piston. But the other thing about these is that the full floating pins, and keep in mind, not all engines are full floating, but the FE Big Block Ford engine just happens to be. Now, what we did to these connecting rods, first of all, if you're going to reuse connecting rods, which we are here, we went ahead and we pulled the old studs out, and we did what we call resizing the rod. That consists of, we shaved a little bit of material off the mating surface of the cap and a little bit of material off the mating surface of the rod. And then once we got that done, we pressed our new ARP rod studs in. You actually have to relieve, you got to put a bigger chamfer up here where the stud goes in, but I don't want to get into all that. There's lots of videos on that. But we prepped the rods, needless to say, put the new ARP bolts in, use the correct ARP lube on them, and then we torqued them. And because we shaved the caps there, it made the bore smaller. And then we just honed these out on our rod hone. But the other thing is, and that's pretty standard for any connecting rod that you're going to reuse, you don't want to reuse the bolts, and you want to resize this and make sure the big end's round. Connecting rods are very susceptible to becoming out of round because of all the stress. Another thing you want to do is make sure if you're reusing rods, Magnaflux them. Get them wet Magnaflux, make sure there's no cracks. We did all that to these. Now, the full floater is different when we get to the small end. If you'll notice, there is a bronze bushing, and we press the old bronze bushings out and we press new ones in. And these also have to be honed and fit to the pin. So we press the bushing in and we set it up on our hone and we hone out. It's a very close tolerance fit here on this pin, but you can see the pin slides through there. Okay, so this is also a full floating pin. And it's a really snug fit. I'm putting it in there with no lube whatsoever on it. And it's, once you put a little lube on there, it frees up a little bit. But these are freshly honed bushings. It's called rebushing the rod. And it's a full floater. The pin floats in the rod, and it also floats in the piston. So you can literally take the full floater. And of course, you want to make sure that your rod is the correct orientation here. You can literally take, you want to put a little bit of oil on these when you actually final assemble them. You just slide your pin in there, and then you slide your pin right on through. You can see I slid that all the way through. And so the pin literally is floating in the rod and it's floating in the piston. And then there's a C-clip that goes in there. You take your snap ring pliers and you put your C-clip in there, and there's a groove, and it has a C-clip that goes on both sides. I'm not going to do that to this yet because this isn't ready to be final assembled. But that's basically the full floating piston. So if you hear the term full floater, that's what they're talking about. This is actually much better for performance. Most of the aftermarket performance rods you buy are going to be full floating bushings. We put, a good example is this small block Ford here. We got aftermarket forged rods. It's a little stroker engine that we did, and it had bushings in it. But the thing is, the rods from the factory, and I've just got an old Chevy rod here that's a semi-floater. If you try to put these together, the pin does not go in. The pin is actually larger than the bore. This type of connecting rod, which is very typical of a lot of OEM engines, you actually have to put the rod in a rod heater, and you have to temporarily swell the small bore of the rod, and then we have a fixture where we slide the pin in. I actually have a couple of videos where I'm doing that. The 289 or 302 build that I did a few years ago, I did the whole series on it. There's actually I'm actually going through the process of heating the rods and putting them together, and I think maybe there's a 350 or 383 or something where I'm putting the rods together with a rod heater. But that's the fundamental difference. The semi-floaters, the reason that manufacturers do the semi-floating thing is it's just cheaper to manufacture this. For performance engines, it's actually better to go with a full floating pin with a bush rod. Now, some engines have this, like the 390FE is full floating from the factory, and so we redid the rods. But you can also upgrade your other engine, whether it's a small block Chevy, Ford, or whatever you're building. You can buy connecting rods that are designed to work with a full floating pin, and I recommend that you do that. So hopefully that makes sense. So that's the two types of rods that you may run into, semi-floater and full floater. That's all I got for you today. I just wanted to make a short, quick video on that because I'm getting there's so much disinformation and confusion on that. I wanted to clear it up. So hopefully that makes sense to you. Stay tuned. I got the 390 stroker coming up. I got the LS build coming up. I got all kinds of stuff coming soon, I promise. I'm basically just waiting on parts right now. I still don't have the balance job back from the 390 stroker. They said it was going to be 2 weeks. It's been a month and I still don't have it back. They're busy. That's the way it goes. So stay tuned and I will talk to you very soon, I promise. Thanks for watching.